Students, in this video we are going to learn how to derive Boolean expressions from a truth table. Till now you have made a truth table from a Boolean expressions. Okay, so here we are going to derive a Boolean expressions from a truth table. Okay, the reverse. Till now whatever expression you have done, that is, you have only all of you have only one Boolean expressions, and from that Boolean expressions you have gotten truth table and logic gates, etc., like this way, whatever you have done with Boolean expression. But here we are going to learn how to derive the Boolean expressions from a truth table. So before that, we have to know the representations of a Boolean expressions or Boolean functions. There are two type of representations of a Boolean expressions. So every Boolean expressions representations is known as canonical form. Canonical form. Okay, every type of Boolean expressions has known as canonical form. So there are two types of canonical form. One is SOP form. SOP form means known as sum of product. Product. Okay, I am doing these two simultaneously so that you can understand it properly. And another one is POS, that is product of sum. Okay, two types of canonical form for every Boolean expressions. One is sum of product and another is product of sum. So let us see what it would be. So for sum of product, we have known that suppose our there is a Boolean expressions, suppose for two variable. So for two variable, that means we can write that like this way. F of 2 AB, that means this is a functions of Boolean expressions having two variable. If we write f either f of ab or small f of xy, so that means this is a functions of a Boolean variable having two variables x and y. This is also a function of Boolean variable, Boolean expressions having two variable f ab. So we can write f a b equals to either a plus ab, like this way. So this is a Boolean expression having two variable. Or we can write if ab, this also a Boolean expressions, ab by ab. Okay, this is for two variables. Okay, so but for if we write for three variables, suppose if x, y, z, that means this is a Boolean functions having three variables. So three variables means we can write like this way, x, y plus y, z bar, x plus y, z. Easily we can write this because there is also three variables, na? X, y, y, z, x, z, x. Here also x, y, z, suppose x, y, z bar, x bar, y, z plus suppose x, y bar, z bar. This is also a Boolean expression. Now what I am going to say, just notice it minutely. In this Boolean expression here, although this is a two variable expressions, there may be, there are two term. We can write here also another term like this way, no problem. Okay, because this is also two variable, no problem. There may be one term, two term, maximum there may exist four term, whatever may be. But you can see here that in these expressions, there is one term which contains only one variable, not both the variable. These two terms have two variables, but these expressions contains one term having a single variable. Okay, but why it is called sum of product? That means all the every expression exists as a product of each term is a product term, and we do summation of each product term. So this is a product term. Product means AND operation. This is also product term. This is also product term. Product term means if we write A into 1. Okay. So every term is a product term, and we do sum of every product term. That why it's called sum of product. So sum of product means product is done before, then we do sum operations. Here also, this is a product term. This is also product term. Three term having three variables. This is also product term. And we do sum of the three product term. That's why this type of expressions known as sum of product expressions. That means sum of product. Product is done before, then we do sum operations. Okay. But what is the difference between this expression and this expression? These expressions have three term. Okay. But these three term, there contains one single term which contains a single variable. But in this expression contains two term, but this two term contains all the variables. Clear? Here also these functions contains three variables, but here this term contains two variables, not all the variables. This term also contain two variables, not all the variables. Only one term contain all the variables. Okay. But in this expression you can see there are three terms, but all the three terms contains all the three variables of the Boolean functions. Clear? So this the expression, that means these expressions star and these expressions, these two expressions star of Boolean functions contains all the terms having all the variables. Okay. So if the product term contains all the variables, all the variables, then it is referred as minterm expressions. Minterm expression. So here this expression contains all the terms of the variable. So these expressions can call SOP expression as well as minterm expression. But this expression is not a minterm expression because there contains two terms which does not have all the, which did not carry all the variables. Okay. So here also this expression is not a minterm expression, but this expression is a minterm expression. So in our conclusions, what we say that every minterm expression, so minterm expressions also SOP expressions, but all SOP expressions in non minterm expression, because this is also SOP expression, this is also SOP expressions, but as this expression does not contain all the variables, so this is not minterm expression, but this is minterm expression. So our conclusion is every minterm expression is SOP expression, but every SOP expression is not minterm expression. So this is our conclusion. Okay. Now let us see what is product of sum. Okay, so for product of sum of two variables, we have already done this type of expressions. If we write like this way, a plus b bar, a bar plus b bar. So a plus b bar for two variable. Here you can see that product of sum, that means sum is done before, then for every sum term we do product operations. Okay, that means in this expression product is done before, then we do sum operation, and here sum is done before, then we do product operations. All of you do the truth table of this, like this operation, and also the logic gate. So this type of expression is known as product of sum. That means sum is done before, then we do product operation. Suppose if for three variable x, y, z, we can write like this way, x, y, x plus y plus z bar, x plus z bar. Okay, or we can write if x, y, z, x plus y plus z, x bar, y bar plus z, x plus y plus x, y bar, z. Okay, so here also you can see that this is two variables, and here every term contains both the variable a plus b, a minus b. This is functions of three variables, but here this term, there are three terms, 1, 2, 3, but this term contain two variable, not three variable. This is three variables, but this term contain two variables. In this expression there are three term, but all the term contains the all the variables. Okay, so here also, as in the sum of product, if the term, each term contain all the variable, then as it is a mean term, in product of sum, if the term in POS expression contain contains all the variables, then it is known as max term. Okay, in SOP expressions it is known as min term, in POS expression it is known as max terms, if each term contain all the variable of Boolean functions. So here also every max term is in POS expressions, but every POS expressions is not a max term. So we can say every max term expression is, max term expression is POS expressions, but every POS expression is not max term expressions. Okay, so this is our, what is min term and max term. Now one thing for max term expression, that in max term expressions every variable should be individually separated like this way, having complement. But this is a max term expressions, ठीक है? Or but if we write a plus b plus c whole bar, then this will not a max term expression, because whole bar contains is not a max term expression, or less max term expression contains individual variable. Okay, now let us see the max term and min term value for each term, how we get this term from a truth table. Okay, so let us see in a truth table. So here in this truth table, let us see the min term and max term value for each value in a truth table. This is a three variable truth table. So in me for min term expressions in a truth table, so this is a three variable truth table, and we know that the for three variable truth table, 40, 41, 20, 21, 23, 21, and every number should be 0, 1, 2, up to 7. For three variable, we know that we have combinations of 8, that means 2 to the power 3, 8, we get 8 combinations. Okay, so I have written here all the values in the truth table. Now for min term, you should notice that for 0 variable, we should write complement of that variable. Okay, for 1, we get normal variable. That means, just notice it very carefully. That is for A, B, C, three variable means, we know that in our logic gets three variable like this way, A, B, C. One is A, B, C, and here it is 0, 0 means A for 0, B for 0, C for 0. So for every distinct variable, if its value is 0, for min term expressions, it should be noted as A bar. That means for 0, this x, and we know that min term expression means this is product expressions. Okay. Min term expression is product expression, max term expression is sum expression. So it is product expressions. Okay, and this is sum expressions. So for min term value, we should write here product expression means A is 0, that means we should write A bar, B is 0, B bar, C is 0, C bar. That means for 0, 0, 0, the expression should be A bar, B bar, C bar. Okay. And as for every, it is for 0 value of I, then it is noted as M0. Clear? For 2 value, it is, you can see A for 0, B for 0, C for 1. That means A for 0 means A bar, B for 0 means B bar, C for 1 means C1, and as it is for 1, so we should write here M1. This is for small m. Okay, now for 2, A is 0, that means A bar, B is 1, that means B, C is 0, C bar, so it is M2. For 3 value, A is 0, A bar, B is 1, C is 1, that means B, C. It is for M3. For 4, 4 means 1, 0, 0, that means A is 1, B is 0 means B bar, C is 0 means C bar. This is M4. For M5, 1, 0, 1, that means A is 1, B is 0 means B bar, C is 1 means C. This is M5. For 6, 1 for A, B for 1, C is 0, C bar. That is M6. For 7, both are 1, so it is A, B, C. These are all mean term value for each value in truth table of three variables. Okay, as it is product, so all the variables should be represented as product form. And for max term means here just reverse of mean term. In reverse, 0 is complement, so in max term, 1 is complement and 0 is normal value. And as it is sum, then it should be like this way. For 0, A Z plus B plus C, and it is capital M 0. Just reverse of this, complement of this, you can say. Okay, all of you know De Morgan's theorem. If we complement the mean term, that means mean term complement, we get max term easily. Okay, so here let us see, just for example, first example, A bar, B bar, C bar, whole complement. We know according to De Morgan's theorem, there are three variables, 1, 2, 3. The product of three variables using De Morgan's theorem, that means x dot y dot z bar whole bar equals to x bar plus y bar plus z bar. Here x is A complement, so we can write like this way, A double bar plus B double bar plus C double bar. Here x, A bar is x, so A plus B plus C. That means if we complemented mean term, we get max term. If we complemented max term, we get mean term. Clear? But here we don't need to do complement. We just take this way and represent like this. So for 0, max term is normal. That means A, B is 0 plus B, C is 1. That means C complement. M1. For this one, A is 0. That means A, B is 1, B complement plus C is 0. That means C. This is M2. Why 2? This is for two variables. Okay, for two number of term. Then this way, A is 0, that means A, B is 1, B complement, C is 1, C complement. This is M3. Okay, now for 4, A is 1, that means A complement, B is 0, that means plus B, C is 0, that means plus C. This is M4. For 5, A1, that means A complement, B0, that means B, C1, that means C complement, M5. 6, A is 1, that means A complement, B is 1, B complement, plus C, M6. For 7, both are 1, that means A complement, plus B complement, plus C complement. So this is our M7. Clear? So this is our mean term and max term notation for each value in function. So how we get Boolean expressions from a truth table? Suppose, for example, I am writing here functions of, mind it very carefully, x, y, z, three variables. For mean term product, okay, mean term, what is mean term notation? Is we should write like this way. This is mean term notation, sum of small m, sorry, small m, 0, 4, 6, 7. If we write like this, this is as small m, this is mean term expressions. Mean term expression. If any expression is given like this, this is mean term expressions. Why mean term expression? Mean term expressions means every Boolean expression should be sum of either mean term expressions or sum of product or max term expression or product of sum. As it is given in small m 0, 4, 6, this means sum. So we can write this like this way, small m 0 plus small m 4 plus small m 6 plus small m 7. As it is small m. Okay, so small m means mean term, so that's why I am saying that it is mean term expression. So mean term expressions, we have to write the complete boolean expression. So at first we are breaking this expression like this way, and then from truth table, we need truth table, otherwise we can't write the expressions. M0 means here first term. So M0 expression is A bar, B bar, C bar, but instead of A, B, C, here the variables are X, Y, Z. So M0 we should write X bar, Y bar, Z bar. Okay. So M0, X bar, Y bar, Z bar plus. Now it is M4. Let us see for M4. M4 is A, B bar, C bar. So instead of A, B, C, we should write X, Y, Z. So A, B bar, C bar. Therefore, we should write X, B bar means Y bar, Z bar. Okay. Now M6. M6 means A, B, C bar. So A, B, C bar means X, Y, Z bar. Plus, sorry, this is not 4, this is 7. For M7 means last value X, Y, Z. So it should write X, Y, Z. Okay, so here you can see this is sum of product. Because sum is done before, then we do product operation. This is product of all the sum variable, sum of all the product variable. Product variable means mean term variable. Why it is mean term variable? Because every term should contain all the three variables of the function. So that's why it is known as mean term expressions. Clearly? Clear? So, I have already said that every mean term expression is also a SOP expressions. Okay. But not every SOP expression is a mean term expression. So, if any SOP expression is given, we can convert it into mean term expressions. We will learn it later. Now, this is for mean term expression, and suppose for max term expressions, I am writing here, if suppose our values are A, B, C, small a, B, C. As summation notation is for mean term, pi notation is for max term. And for max term, we use capital M. Suppose our max term is 1, 3, 5, 7. Okay, so here the variables are, we should write the expression with the variables given in the functions. Okay, so here the variables are small a, b, c. So our expression should contain these variables. So at first we have to break these variables. So we should break these variables like this way, like our mean term. So this is max term expression, that means product of sum. So this is max term expression or, so you can break this M1 dot max term expression or POS expression, that means product of sum. Okay, so M1 dot M3, because dot is in between, as here is in between plus, for every term there should be plus sign, and for max term there should be dot sign, because we have product is due later and sum is due first. So M5 dot M7. Okay, now for M1, let us find out the value from M1. Our value is A plus B plus C bar. Okay, so here our variable is small abc, so we should write A plus B plus C bar. For M1 dot M3. For M3, A plus B bar plus C bar. So A plus B bar plus C bar. Okay. For M5, A bar plus B plus C bar. A bar plus B plus C bar. For M7 means our last value, A bar plus B bar plus C bar. That means A bar plus B bar plus सी बार. ओके, सो दिस इज हाउ वी गेट मीन टर्म एंड मैक्स टर्म एक्सप्रेशंस फ्रॉम ए ट्रूथ टेबल. ओके, नाउ इन आवर सेकेंड वीडियो वी विल सी हाउ वी रिप्रेजेंट्स ए एसओपी एक्सप्रेशंस इन ए मीन टर्म एक्सप्रेशन वाइस वर्सा. क्लियर?